Hi, I'm very excited because this is my first ever video on this channel. So in today's talk, we'll talk about difference between rework and repair as per IATF 16949-2016. Hello, I'm Arun Kumar Sharma. I'm the founder and CEO of SubMastery. And today we are going to talk about what is the difference between these two terms. So first of all, we should know that why this is important to know this term. As you can see, because if a product is non-conforming or a product is a non-conformity product, then it could have three decisions. It could go for rework, it could be even go for repair, or it could be even scrap. Well, we are very much aware about what is scrap. So scrap is something which goes to sale or which goes to third party, which can't be used by the organization again during its production. So I believe scrap is very much clear to most of the people, but there is a kind of confusion between rework and repair, and we need to understand this difference in a very, very right way. At the same time, in IATF, this clause 8.7.1.4 and 8.7.1.5, this is a special clause. So it is also important to understand the requirement as per IATF. So which definition to follow? As you might be aware that there are so many definitions about rework and repair floating on the internet. But one thing, yes, we need to understand that we need to follow the language and we need to follow the definition of ISO 9000. Because if we follow the definition of ISO 9000, then only that will be our interpretation of IATF standard. If we start following some other definition given in some other standards, or if we start following the definition of Oxford Dictionary or a simple English definition, it will add more to our confusion. So whenever we talk about IATF standard or whenever we talk about any of the definition, first of all we should refer to the definition given in the ISO 9000. If there are no definition given in ISO 9000, then we can refer some other standards as well. But the first priority, follow the ISO 9000 definition. Okay, so what is the definition of a rework as per ISO 9000? It says that action on a non-conforming product, which clearly indicates that the action need to be taken on non-conforming product to make it conform to the requirement. So this is quite simple, that if we take some action on non-conforming product and as per drying, as per standard, the product become conform, product become okay as per the original requirement. Okay, so unless until we take some example, this might not be clear for some people. Let's take some example of rework. Suppose we are doing some machining work and by mistake the drill size was made undersized and the observation was 16.20 mm and the standard was 19.20 mm. That may be because of wrong drill size selection, or maybe because of the drill was worn out. So it might be the case. The point is that the product, the drill is undersized. Now the action taken was that the drilling operation was done again and with the right size of drill, and what was the result? The result was that product is now okay as per original drying and standard, and thus we can say that because the product is now 100% as per original drying and specification and standard, and thus we can say that this is a classic example for rework. Yeah, are you with me? Okay, now let us try to understand the definition of repair. Action on a non-conforming product, so which clearly indicates that yes, the repair also happen after our product is non-conforming, to make it acceptable for the intended use. Now when we say intended use, what does it mean? Intended use means that product is used on the basis of functional, And in the note, they have given that it can be that in conjunction with a repair, a concession is required. So it clearly indicates that when repair is happening, then the product is made suitable for intended use, means it is made suitable for function, and it also says that with repair, you may need a deviation. Okay, so we'll see some example, and once we see some example, this will become crystal clear. Let's see some example. Okay, so let's say one example that nut was not properly welded and it came out. So the problem was that the welding doesn't took place in a proper way. So what we did, the operator did two additional welding joint. Okay, so there were already some joint and the operator did two additional welding joints so that it doesn't come out. So you can see that in the result side, that in the drawing and standard, there was a requirement in the standard, there was a requirement that there need to be only two welding points, but we end up having four joints. So we can say that here there is no issue in the function, but as per drawing or standard, it was not done. So we can say that this is a classic example of repair, because we might not be sure about what happened to those two additional joint. They came out, but still we did two additional joints. So we can say that this is an example of repair where we have done something additional as per the drawing or standard requirement. Okay, so let's take one another example. Say drilling of a hole in the wrong place. Okay, so there was a drilling in the wrong place, and the action taken was, now the drilling of hole was done in the right place and we plugged the hole in the wrong place. So what happened? This resulted into extra plugging hole. There's an extra hole, and it is not as per standard drawing or requirement, although it might not be mentioned on the drawing, but you know, there's something additional which was done and which is not the requirement of a standard. So we can say that this product might be used, it is okay as per function, but it is not as per the standard or drawing, because nowhere in drawing or standard it is mentioned that we need two holes or we need one hole with plugged hole. So thus we can say that this is a classic example for repair. Okay, so let us try to sum up the difference between these two. Number one, after rework, product is 100% confirmed to original specification. After rework, repair, product is good for intended use, that means it will fulfill the functional requirement. Number two difference is that prior approval of rework from customer is not compulsory, only if it is a customer specific requirement we need approval. And in case of repair, it is given in IATF that you must take approval or deviation from customer even prior to start repair work. Obviously, because in rework we do not need any deviation mandatory from customer, which also shows that doing rework has a lower risk, and while you need customer deviation, he may need some testing, and which indicates that repair is a higher risk item. Okay, so if there are any similarities, yes. Let's see what are these similarities. Number one, both of these require mandatory document process. So both of them require instructions for re-inspection and traceability requirement. We need how exactly we are going to do, what are the steps and the sequence we need to do. So we need to find out the way, what could be the instruction, and this instruction could be written, this instruction could be visual instruction as well. Yes, a defect phenomena or what are the risks associated, these need to be mentioned in FMEA, because we should know that whether we are going to do repair or rework, we should know that what are the risks associated and whether these defect phenomena have been identified in FMEA. It is important. We need the documented information, some kind of evidence where we need to show the how much quantity of rework or repair was done, and what was the actual disposition, what happened to those, either they were scrapped or what happened to them, including traceability requirements. So these are the four similarities between them. Okay, so I hope you enjoy this requirement, and if you have any question, just comment and write to me. I'll be happy to answer your question. Goodbye.